The SpaceX Starship offers extraordinary potential benefits for the exploration and development of space by both the public and private sectors. It will enable many new commercial space ventures, as well as dramatically lower the costs and raise the frequency of scientific missions that will provide amazing new knowledge about our universe and home planet. Its relatively clean environmental footprint, the large savings it offers U.S. taxpayers. As a means of transport for government programs and missions, and its ability to rapidly and regularly deliver satellite constellations and payloads to orbit, will enhance national security, increase high-paying jobs in the space sector, and propel American space leadership far ahead of any global competitors. Therefore we, the undersigned organizations, strongly urge the Federal Aviation Administration, and other federal agencies to provide full approval to SpaceX, to begin orbital test flights of the Starship at the earliest possible date. The Federal Aviation Administration has announced that, the completion of a crucial, environmental assessment, SpaceX needs to begin orbital-class Starship launch attempts out of South Texas. A group of 14 space advocacy organizations published a joint statement, urging rapid U.S. government approval of SpaceX's Starship test flights. Commenting on the initiative, Mars Society President Dr. Robert Zubrin said, "The organizations that have come together to make this statement represent every point of view within the space community. Whether one's priority is settling Mars, developing space commerce, exploring the Moon, assuring national security, or gaining new knowledge of the Earth, the planets, or the universe, we all agree that it is vital that this program be allowed to move forward. There may be many more hurdles like this, that SpaceX and others seeking to open the space frontier will face. But this statement shows that the often fractured movement of space, advocates can come together to help when it really counts." Official known as a programmatic environment assessment, the FAA says it started the process in late June 2021. With the goal of verifying that SpaceX's Starbase orbital launch site was mostly benign before the end of 2021. Compared to a regular EA, the programmatic nature of SpaceX's Starbase review would theoretically allow the company to start small and gradually expand and add new facilities and capabilities, without having to restart the arduous review process for each change. Along those lines, SpaceX's first draft P requested permission for no more than 5 full-stack Starship launches per year. Compared to the maximum of 12 Falcon 9 launches, or 9 Falcon 9, and 3 Falcon Heavy launches, out of Boca Chica, that SpaceX had already received permission for from the FAA in 2014. Unfortunately, even at the time that the start of the process was announced, completing a full P in half a year was already unbelievably optimistic. No comparable review, of which there are effectively none, has been completed anywhere close to that quickly. In the face of substantial local opposition, like in the case of Georgia's Camden Spaceport, even an FAA environmental review for a relatively small rocket launch facility can make little progress after years of tooth and nail fighting. However, the best possible comparison has always been SpaceX's own environmental assessment for an almost identical orbital-class Starship launch site at Florida's Kennedy Space Center. Despite the fact that no untouched ground would be broken, and even with the apparent might of NASA behind it, it took the FAA and SpaceX about a full year to complete a Pad 39A for up to 24 Starship launches per year. As such, the idea that the FAA would be able to complete a P for Boca Chica Starship launches in 6 months was always almost unimaginable. Outside of email chains and boardrooms, however, it's no longer clear that completing the P and securing an FAA launch license are the limiting factor for the first orbital Starship test flights. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk recently announced that SpaceX is changing the prototypes assigned to the first full-stack launch, likely to Booster 7 and Ship 24. Super Heavy B7 has yet to begin any kind of testing, and Starship S24 is still in several pieces, so it's safe to say that SpaceX's new pair are months of concerted testing away from launch readiness. If anything goes wrong during those tests, any significant design issues are discovered, or any damage is caused, it's entirely possible that what Elon Musk says could take as few as 2 months will actually take more like 4 to 6. Only time will tell. For now, the FAA likely has a few months before Starship's South Texas P and full-stack launch license truly become the limiting factor for the rocket's first orbital launch attempt. But now, SpaceX needs the green light from the FAA. The company told the FCC that its objective for the first orbital flight test is to collect as much data as possible during flight to quantify entry dynamics and better understand what the vehicle experiences in a flight regime that is extremely difficult to accurately predict or replicate computationally, SpaceX said. This test provides engineers with insight needed to know whether the spacecraft and rocket are capable of withstanding the stresses of spaceflight, and see whether there's any leaks in the structure. The videos of the test procedure suggest that engineers tested ground systems at the launch pad, known as Stage Zero, which includes lines that load propellant into Starship via plumbing on the quick disconnect arm. Once SpaceX completes proof testing, the next phase of testing is expected to be a static fire test of Booster 7's 29 Raptor 2 engines while Starship remains atop. This test is performed with the methalox propellant, liquid methane and liquid oxygen. This data will anchor any changes in vehicle design or concept of operations after the first flight and build better models for us to use in our internal simulations. The assessment looks at environmental impacts of SpaceX's initial mission profile and reviews debris recovery, local road closures in Boca Chica, Texas, where the firm's launch site is located, and other issues. The Starship program aims to develop vehicles for the interplanetary travel of cargo and humans to the Moon, Mars and beyond. However, the Musk-led company still needs to wait for the Federal Aviation Administration to complete its environmental assessment before Starship can leave the ground. To perfect the rockets, SpaceX plans to conduct several test launches over the next few years, all of which will require a permit or vehicle operator license from the FAA. SpaceX already has FAA environmental approval to launch Starship from the East Coast. It started building a second Starship orbital launch tower at NASA's Kennedy Space Center Historic Launch Complex 39A in Cape Canaveral, Florida, where the first crewed flight is expected to lift off from. The company recently announced the Polaris program that is funded by Shift 4 Payments founder Jared Isaacman. The program's crew members will test new SpaceX spacesuits designed for spacewalks, as well as new technologies, aboard a pair of Crew Dragon missions that will lead up to the first crewed Starship spaceflight. If the process of securing a limited license for far less risky suborbital Starship launches is anything to go off of, securing a similar license for orbital Starship launches, with 10 to 20 times the explosive potential, could be an agonizing months-long ordeal. It's ambiguous if the FAA is already deep into that process or if it's waiting for a complete, approved P to begin work on Starship's first orbital launch license. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.